Taoiseach. Taoiseach, can I suggest that the concern you expressed for the young men and women of Ireland in your response there just a moment ago is belied by the very grim reality facing young people in this country as a result of the austerity policies and cuts and unemployment that are resulting from your policies. This grim reality was revealed in the report just published by the Public Health Agency in Northern Ireland and the National Office for Suicide Prevention, which reveals the appalling fact that 165 young people took their own lives in the south of Ireland last year, and that the suicide rate among young people in Ireland is one of the highest in Europe, and that report linked this directly to recession and unemployment. And the report noted that the countries with the highest increases in suicide were Greece with a 17% increase and Ireland with a 13% increase. Taoiseach, can I put it to you that these facts speak for themselves? The austerity policies being pursued by your government and the Troika are producing despair and hopelessness among many young people, leading directly to this shocking increase in suicide. Isn't there a direct connection between young nurses being asked to work for 20% less than nurses who qualified a few years ago, young teachers being asked to work for 30% less than teachers who qualified a few years ago, young junior doctors, a number of whom committed suicide last year, being asked to work unsafe hours in our hospitals, cuts in guidance counsellors for young people when early intervention and prevention is so vital to protect our young people from despair and hopelessness, and chronic unemployment and emigration which disproportionately affect our young people. I ask you simply, Taoiseach, do the young people, young workers, young graduates and young students deserve to pay the price for the crimes of others and for a crisis that is not their fault? Do you not recognise, Taoiseach, if you treat young people as second-class citizens, they will feel like second-class citizens, and therein lies the road to despair. What are you going to do to give hope and a prospect of a future to our young people so they don't feel this level of despair?
Thank you. Taoiseach.
We had some questions on this yesterday. When this government was elected to office, in the 3 years prior to its moving into government, 250,000 jobs were lost in the private sector in this country. 250,000. They're many of the people that you speak of. It is the challenge of government to rectify the problems inherited here, to rectify our public finances, to change the structures of the way we do business, to grow our economy and to create jobs. You cannot do that, Deputy Boyd Barrett, unless there is trust, unless there is an understanding that this country will do as it says it's doing. And at long last, there are signs of confidence, of investor confidence, of investment confidence in the country, international reputation restored, and moving in the right direction. Now, I sympathise, Deputy Boyd Barrett, I sympathise with every family in this country that's lost a life through suicide. I've been in many of their homes and many of their houses, and that unspeakable questions always remain. Should I have seen something? Was there a question I should have asked? Was there something I should have done? Now, you make the point in your normal charge here that this is a continuing austerity by government. Well, Minister Kathleen Lynch, who has a genuine interest in this area, has been given a budget which is ring-fenced dealing with the general area. But I point out to you, you might be quiet about a serious matter for once, Deputy McGrath. The budget for the National Office for Suicide Prevention has actually increased from 4.1 million to 8.1 million. Your colleague is talking about austerity and cuts in the area. Everybody understands the enormous amount of work that is going into to attempt to prevent this phenomenon from continuing at the rate that it's happened in the country here. And from that point of view, the report published today by Minister Lynch by the Men's Health Forum in Ireland will indicate, unfortunately, that the suicide rate is one of the highest in Europe, and that in Ireland, for young males between 20 and 24, and for females aged between 50 and 54. And the latest data show that 552 people committed suicide in Ireland in 2009, for which the latest figures were available. So the allocation of the ring-fenced $35 million for 2012 was used primarily, I can't call it, to strengthen the community mental health teams in adult and children's mental health services. Some of those funds will be used to advance further suicide prevention measures and to initiate the provision of psychological and counselling services in primary care, especially for people with mental health problems. The announcement in the budget for 2013 of a further $35 million for the continued development of our mental health services is important. That means the recruitment of 470 additional staff to implement these measures. But it's not always about that, Deputy Boyd Barrett. The young generation get their information in a very different way than you or I did when we were growing up. And there are always different pressures on young minds. And this is a sad fact that this is an issue about which there are now a huge range of organisations, groups, teams, agencies working. And that's where Minister Lynch wants to concentrate in having really effective connection with young people so that this issue, which is so tragic, can be prevented. I'm able to inform the House of Kilmacduagh that the National Office of Suicide Prevention has actually implemented most of the recommendations in the strategy in a four-way report or approach, delivering a general population approach to mental health promotion and suicide prevention, using targeted programmes for people at higher risk, delivering services to individuals who have engaged in deliberate self-harm, and providing support to families and communities that are bereaved by suicide. I agree with you from this perspective, Deputy Boyd Barrett. There are 26 million unemployed in the European Union. 29% of young people in Ireland are unemployed. It's 3% in Germany and in Austria. So part of the presidency priorities for this government as presidency of the Union will be to work specifically in the area of youth employment and opportunities for young people to be employed. We all agree and understand that they are the future of this country and of the European Union. But the challenge for the government is to get those decisions made in the first instance which will allow for that indigenous confidence to come back, where young people can see motivation and opportunity, and give them a demonstration that hope is not just an aspiration, that it actually can come in by people and government working together here and with our European colleagues to provide those opportunities.
Thank you.
I've just met so many people over the last number of months who are really driven by the opportunity that presents itself. And I do see signs of confidence returning, Deputy Boyd Barrett, and the news from our colleagues in Europe over the last number of days, as Minister Noonan pointed out, is significant, but not a game changer. We have to help create that game changer ourselves.
Thank you.
And well you may be cynical, Deputy Martin, when you left behind you, and you left behind you a legacy that no other government in the history of this state had to face, and which we are dealing with.
Thank you. Deputy Boyd Barrett, thank you.
You shouldn't have bothered tugging out the game changer.
Go there at all for? Sorry, are you representing the technical group now, or is it Deputy Boyd Barrett?
Taoiseach, you're not really getting the point of the question. The report says that while death rates from suicide decreased by 15% between 2000 and 2007, a reversal of this pattern coincided with the onset of recession in 2008. The countries with the highest suicide rate increases were those most affected by the recession, Greece and Ireland. You were written to by a junior doctor, as were we all, earlier this year, or at the end of last year, a doctor who has since emigrated, where he said the illegal working hours being performed by myself and my colleagues is leading to suicides, burnout, depression, alcohol misuse and road traffic accidents and deaths. The same sense of despair is being felt by young people who either can't find work.
Thank you.
Or in the cases of young nurses and young teachers, are being treated as second-class citizens, being asked to work with the same responsibilities and the same long hours for 20 or 30% less than people who qualified
Thank
a few
you, Deputy,
years ago.
Would you put your question?
My point is this, Taoiseach. Isn't it the case that the policies of cuts and austerity that you are imposing are leading directly to the sense of despair and hopelessness
Thank you.
That is being felt among young people that are leading to this increase in suicide rates? Words about doing things about youth unemployment are no good
Sorry,
if the
Deputy.
Policies being pursued are actually leading directly to youth unemployment and despair among young people generally.
Thank you. Taoiseach.
Well, that's why there was no increase in income tax for anybody in the country, because we believe that a tax on jobs is an imposition on that hope.
Sorry.
You had your chance. You had your chance. You had your chance. I don't believe in having any discrimination among the citizens in the country here. But you fail to understand. You fail to understand that when it was assumed that the veneer of invincibility of previous governments in the last number of years could keep paying at the rates that money was being doled out at, we now have to deal with the challenge that we will never have our country right unless we deal with our public finances, unless we deal with that deficit, and we can only deal with that ourselves, Deputy Boyd Barrett. You seem to think that you can continue to pay exceptional salaries on fantasy money. I believe that many of those young people would be more than willing to build on their graduate experience and work in Irish hospitals as Irish nurses on salaries that are equivalent to what starts off in the accountancy sector or the teaching sector. Yes, they're not as high as salaries in the past, but they are job opportunities for the future. So, just for your information, in 2012, the 12 million that was allocated for suicide prevention, 7.1 million went to the National Office for Suicide Prevention. The remaining 5 million was used regionally to fund resource officers for suicide prevention, self-harm liaison nurses in hospital emergency departments, and a number of local suicide prevention issues. And a further million is being provided to the National Office from the additional monies allocated for this year, bringing that total to 8.1 million, and a special programme of measures to further advance suicide prevention in 2013 is currently being developed by Minister Lynch. In 2012, 414 posts were approved, 135 posts were filled, 208 have been accepted, subject to process clearances, guard the vetting and so on, and the remainder are at various stages of selection, and the same will apply for this year. I admit that the appointment of personnel and the money is not all the answer to the problem. But what is the answer to giving hope and inspiration to young people is government working effectively with our colleagues in Europe, demonstrating that the economics of our country are coming right and that the job opportunities, which you should have listened to the national media in the last 3 days, where even they were surprised at the positive news of investment and job creation in the country. And that's where the hope lies. That's where the hope lies for the future. But you don't want to believe that, because you have a vested interest in seeing the country not thrive and not prosper. But we're moving away from your position of wanting demonstrations every day. We want to give hope and inspiration and a demonstration that things do work for young people. And I'm glad to see that that's moving in the right direction. Someday you might realise it.
That completes the questions for today. Let's now move